For this assignment, start the new Inventor program in English units, and then start a new sketch on XY plane. And your initial sketch would shape like an L shape. That's what we will start from the origin to constrain fully is the best to begin always from origin, that yellow dot in the middle, and create the L shaped sketch. Don't be concerned about the size at the beginning. Just go ahead, finish all your lines, and make sure all the lines are having the perpendicular relations, and then come back and add dimensions. 0.75 for the width, and then height, and the base. All the dimensions that requires for this to be fully constrained. This one is 4.5. And also add the height dimension would be another 2.5 units. And there's one more dimension on the thickness would be 0.75. That should fully define your sketch. And notice on the status bar that shows fully defined. Fully constrained. And now we will use extrude command, and extrude will equal to the depth, which in this case we what's given on the handout is 3 inches or 3 units. Okay, so we have created the 3D model right now. There are a few more things we need to do. One is the cut that corner. You see the corner has been cut in kind of a triangular shape. For that, we're going to click the right face, and on that face, we create this triangle. As you are creating this triangle, make sure that fully constrained. And so then add all the necessary dimensions. If you go through the handout sheet, you will notice that that's 1 unit and by 1 unit. Once you define both of them, that should be fully constrained. In case you don't see that, maybe the line is not collinear, then we can add some more relations. So that is fully constrained. We will use the extrude, and this time we're going to extrude and remove the material. That means we're going to select the cut option, the middle option. Click on the tab and then cut through all. Always it's a good idea to go through all. Don't give any thickness for future changes. That would be the best option. On the top plane, on that face, we create a new sketch, and that sketch is going to be a rectangle shape this time. And we will have that rectangle drawn using the 2 points rectangle. Would be a good option here. Create 2 points and then create the rectangle. 2 points rectangle, pick the point 1, and then move your cursor to select point 2, as you are seeing on this illustration. And again, don't be concerned about the exact location at this point, then come back and add required dimensions. Point 5, and then size. This one is going to be 2 units, and then that leaves you with the thickness, which would be another given dimension of 1.5. So that's fully constrained. And we will use extrude cut. The last thing we're going to go draw the circle. And circle is on that face. As you see here, we have the size. 0.75 diameter, and we need to locate exactly where the circle is, which represents the hole on this piece. and it's given, let's define two directions, x and y directions, to locate precisely where the hole would be. And 1 inch from right side, and then from the base you can add another dimension, given perfectly should be 1.5, is in the midpoint of that piece. And then after that we'll again use the extrude cut. As you saw on this assignment, we have been using the line and extrude to create this model. Check for accuracy, going through the documentation, and that completes your project for this assignment. And that should save your work also.